Hey guys, Joel here, GreyWolf TV, and it is that time of the week. We are back with Star Trek Picard. We're on to episode 5. So, little quick recap. Previous episode, we are on our way to Freecloud with a slight diversion to pick up an old friend of Picard who he's known since he was a child, who is now going to bind. He did say that a lot. His sword and come and help him on his quest. Some sort of warrior nun who he's known since he was a kid, called Elnor. And as they were leaving, they got into a battle with an old bird of prey, and a little ship seemed to help them out, and then the captain of that ship requested to be beamed aboard because it was too heavily damaged. And lo and behold, the captain of the little ship turns out to be 7 of 9. That's pretty much where we left it. So we're going to go and see if we are now going to get to Freecloud and locate Bruce Maddox. Hopefully there won't be any more weird, strange quirks in this episode. And please, no more F-bombs. Let's go. Episode 5.
7.
You'll be all right.
Go.
No, not without you, Egypt.
Egypt.
I'm so sorry. My child.
The hell are you doing out here, Picard? Besides being in way over your head? Ranging is my job. It's not saving the galaxy. It's helping people who have no one else to help them. It's hopeless and pointless and exhausting, and the only thing worse would be giving up. Who are you looking for?
Someone who has no one else to help her. Someone who will likely die if I don't.
She goes by 7.
7?
Mm-hmm.
The ex-Borg Fenris Ranger.
I heard she's from the Delta Quadrant.
And I somehow managed to forget that Picard used to be Borg too. Must have happily blocked it out.
I found him, JL.
You found Maddox?
Party named the Jaisal is holding him. They're looking for someone to broker a deal with the
Tal Shiar.
Without Maddox, we'll never find Daj's sister. Options.
Give the Jaisal something she wants in exchange for Maddox. Something she'll find irresistible.
Like what?
Like me.
That many implants in a living specimen. Impossible. So many intact and functioning Borg parts in a single specimen. She would be extremely valuable.
Disgusting thing. Once they get the Borg inside them, there is no coming back, no matter what they think. Defiled is what you are. Damn!
Oh God, this is cringe.
What applies? Let's see if there's a deal to be made.
Now that's the kind of talk that I like. But one last thing. I need proof that my bounty is alive. I need to see Maddox!
I hope you find what you came out here for.
And I sincerely wish the same for you.
You know, there was a time where it meant the world to me to hear you say that.
Well, Gabriel.
So what? You changed. You're different now.
I'm putting my life back together.
The attack on Mars. Tell me how it wasn't really the sins.
Honey.
Tell me about the Conclave of 8. Tell me what was worth ignoring me and Dad. Until we hardly recognized you. Why you abandoned us for some crackpot tin hat conspiracy.
It wasn't crackpot! Will you be staying a while?
No, like I said, she's just passing by.
Something's not right, we may have to abort. Do you have a lock on them?
Are you still angry because I carved up your little friend for parts? Or is it because you trusted me? Oh, you were so noble then.
Wrong, Jay. Drop your weapons.
Listen to her.
Now! I was not entirely candid with you.
I got them today.
Picard.
Picard? The famous Admiral Picard? I take it you had no awareness of Annika and my close personal relationship.
Shut up!
This is just settling an old score.
You have no idea what this is.
He was the closest thing I will ever have to kin.
Like me, Ichab was a former Borg, rescued and reclaimed by Voyager in the Delta Quadrant. That's why she wanted him.
Murder is not justice. There is no solace in revenge.
You guys ready to go yet?
Take them. Activate the pattern enhancer and get them the hell out of here.
I understand the impulse. But you do this, you put a bounty on all of us. I don't give a damn. But the kid and the old man, they don't stand a chance out here with a price on their heads. Hey, look at the math of it is all I'm saying. We found her once, odds are, we'll do it again.
I did it.
I'm glad of the choice you made. It seems that a lift is the least I can offer you.
I will take two of your phasers, if that's all right. A vigilante could always use a couple more. After they brought you back from your time in the Collective, do you honestly feel that you regained your humanity?
Yes.
All of it?
No. But we're both working on it.
Hi.
Picard still thinks there's a place in the galaxy for mercy. I didn't want to disillusion him. You're stalling, Jay. Your second security wave will be here in less than 5 seconds. He was a son to me, Jay. This is for him.
Bruce. Bruce. I have to know. Does she have a sister?
Yes. Soji.
Soji. Where is she?
She's on the artifact.
The artifact? You mean... not the captured Borg cube. Raffi?
Leave me alone.
Welcome back.
Did you get to meet Dodge?
No.
They did it, Ek. Soon and I, your contribution was essential.
That wasn't obvious.
What is the nature of your psychiatric emergency? Your blood pressure and cortisol levels. What is the nature of your medical emergency?
Deactivate EMH. Louis, I didn't know what I know. I wish they hadn't shown me.
Right, so that was episode 5 of Picard. Where do I even begin with this? Right, so the scene with Egypt at the beginning, I think, was... I'm not sure why they put it in. It was a little bit too graphic to introduce him that way and then just kill him off straight away. That was pretty much the only family that Seven of Nine kind of had. It was awful what's happened to him. When did suddenly Borg parts become so a wanted commodity? And why is it now that it seems this so-called utopia that we had, I know a lot of it has been lost, but now there seems to be a complete currency system back in place and the whole universe has gone to shit, and it's just full of murderers, thieves, renegades. I don't know. Anyway, they got Bruce Maddox. It didn't last very long. They've gotten the tiny piece of information out of him that they needed to get, and that is where Hoshi currently is, that she's on the reclamation ship, on... you know, the Borg reclamation ship. So Picard has at least got that amount of information. What he doesn't quite know yet is that Bruce Maddox is now dead, but it's going to lead straight back to the Doctor. Unless, of course, the writers have decided to completely throw the Star Trek rulebook out the window once again and decide that she now has also the capabilities of, one, having enough time on this very small ship. It's not a starship. It's not got 1,000 people on it. A very small ship of a four-man crew, and her having enough time to completely delete all the records of what she's just done, including wiping all knowledge of it from the EMH program and altering all the records of the medical hologram, as well as the medical facility and all the sensors and everything else. But I guess they're going to do that so they don't get to know that she is the spy that's aboard. We kind of knew the Doctor was a spy straight from the off, right back in the chateau when she came in and shot that Romulan in the back and asked, was the gun on a stun setting? The storyline was obvious. The plot line was obvious right from that point. That's my problem with this show. It's so obvious where everything is going. It was lovely to see Seven of Nine. However, she looks fabulous. The Borg implants they put on her do not. They look kind of cheap, nasty, and kind of a bit rubbery, but I don't know, maybe they've run out of budget for the show again. But the overwhelming problem that I found was the acting is getting worse on this show, episode by episode. It's already a convoluted mess. It's already full of plot holes and throwing the Star Trek canon completely out of the window episode by episode. But this was dire, guys. This was absolutely dire. You were taking a figure that we've had on our screens for 20 odd years, Picard, and you're turning him into a bumbling Inspector Clouseau character. What are you doing? That was cringeworthy on a warp factor scale of 10. It was just dreadful. Where are they going with this? Why? You've got one of them dressed up as a pimp. You've got animated cartoon pop-ups on the bridge when it's meant to be a secure ship. So why is the pop-ups coming up the minute they arrive in orbit of this planet? Why are they there? That's the best security measures his ship's got, and all these things popping up. Ugh. I'm trying, guys. I'm trying. But it's starting to reach the point where there is no return from this show. And I am no longer enjoying it. That's the issue. And I feel at this point, I mean, I don't expect it to be perfect. I wanted to see where they finished off with Picard as a storyline. Now he's old, and I accept that things have changed, that it's no longer the perfect Starfleet that it was, but you've turned Starfleet into a dystopia. Like you do with everything else set in the future now. And you've made it into a bunch of murderous, villainous, xenophobic Alpha Quadrant. And it's just a mess. It's awful. It's dreadful. And it's boring. I'm sorry, but it's boring. And the reason it's boring is because it's so badly written. And the woman in it, why is Seven suddenly gay? I don't have a problem with her being gay, but why she's suddenly gay? She used to be with Chakotay. Anyway, that doesn't really matter to the plotline of the show. I guess all they can do now is head towards Romulan space and see if they can go and find Soji. I don't know what's going to happen with the Doctor. Personally, she should now be caught and found out for what she's just done to Bruce Maddox from stopping saying anything else. We don't know why she's done what she's done. I have an idea why she's done, but I'm not going to say anything. The scene with Raffi was also, again, predictable and wasn't actually necessary. And her saying, I'm clean. No, you're not. You're not clean at all. What, you've been clean because you've been on a spaceship for 2 days? No. Right, the bad news, guys, is that was episode 5. there's not going to be an episode 6 from me, I'm afraid. That's as far as is going to go for me on this channel. I only stopped doing a show on this channel for two reasons. One, if it's so unpopular that it's no longer worth the time and investment because you guys as viewers are telling me that you don't want to watch it. And that is reflected in all the analytics and the views and the comments and everything. And I think I've only ever really had to cancel one show based on that. The second reason is for me, and that is when it's something that I can no longer in good conscience continue because I'm not enjoying it, or it's a bad show, or it's badly written, or there's bad acting, or it just doesn't interest me. And unfortunately, I started off with an awful lot of enthusiasm for this show because of what it is and because I'm such a huge Star Trek fan. But this isn't Star Trek. It's not, guys, it's not. This is a mix between a poor man's old carbon versus Blade Runner, set in space, using a Star Trek name, but not in particular the brand or the copyright, because I don't think they can with a lot of it, to try and continue a storyline, to try to make money. And it's a shame, unfortunately, but I can't continue watching and reacting to something that I feel doesn't hold my attention, and me giving a review on something. All's going to happen from this point, if I continue with this series, guys, is me moaning and complaining as a Star Trek fan, as a lot of people currently are online. There's two sides to everything. Everyone's entitled to their opinion, and I am on the side of all of those that are saying what is going on with this series. It's not what it should be, and unfortunately the writers are just completely ignoring all the original source material to be able to push forward their own political agendas in the show, and I don't agree with it. So by all means, go and continue and watch Star Trek Picard for yourselves. I'm sure some of you out there are still enjoying the show for what it is, and that's perfectly fine. However, it will no longer continue on my channel. I will replace it with another show for next week. I will find something else suitable. And I do thank you, all of you that have come and watched the 5 episodes that I've done, and all of you that have commented, and I do appreciate it. And I will be back next week with a brand new show. I don't know what it's going to be yet. I will try and pick something suitable that's sci-fi related or drama related for the channel as normal. So until then, guys, thank you very much for watching. I'm sorry to have to deliver the bad news, but you want me to be able to react and not be a yes man and just say everything's perfect, everything's great, and only put stuff on my channel that I know is going to be a perfect 10 and get all the views and get all the positive comments, because it's worth to put on my channel. And I don't mind getting criticism. I don't mind getting lots of people giving it a video or thumbs down. I've had that on plenty of videos, and I will continue to do a series if it's a worthy series. Even if people don't like it, everyone's entitled to their opinion. But if the series itself is bad, and it's nothing to do with numbers and nothing to do with people who are watching it, it's just the series itself, I can't continue with it. The other one was Another Life, and I started with that one, and it was just awful. And I said on the pilot episode that it was awful, and I myself determined I wasn't going to continue with it. So there you go. Brand new show next week, guys. So until then, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.